Okay, so we're going to have a look at dispersed eye printing today. So what I'd like you to do is choose an A4 photograph. When you're selecting your photograph, I want you to think about the colour, shapes, patterns and textures within the photograph. So I've chosen this one to work with today because firstly there's lots of bright colours happening. So we've got lovely pinks, greens, different shades of blues and greys and browns. And there's lots of lovely shapes within the pebbles and the seaweed for me to pick out later. So we're going to use this as our colour palette. So when we're using the dispersed eyes, they come in these little tubs, and a little goes a very long way. So it's a powder form, so you have got to be careful when you're using them that you don't spill it on the table or on your hands and that you wash your hands afterwards. So the colours, when you take the lids off, you'll see they look very different. So this one says rust brown, but actually I think it looks more like a green colour. And this one's red, which is very dark. So when they're mixed and printed onto the fabric, they will come out a very different colour to what you first see. So it's really important that we blend the colours and do tester samples first of all. So this is what I want you to do before my taster next week. So to mix the dyes, you're going to need a pot of water, a pipette and some paint brushes. So using your pipette, this just makes it much easier and stops spills. Just put a few drops in your mixing palette. So you're only going to need about a teaspoon of water for what we're doing, so a little goes a long way. Then using a paintbrush, just dampen the paintbrush and take any excess water off with a paper towel. So we don't want it dripping, but we just want it damp. So then get the powders. So this is the rust brown. And for the teaspoon of water, I'm just going to dip the tip of the paintbrush into the dye. So it's just coated the paintbrush. That is more than enough for what we need. And then stir it into the water. So stir it around until all the little granules in the powder have disappeared. Okay, so we're going to mix them, but we'll try the colours as they are as well. So it's a good idea on a test piece of paper to just do a little square, and you can build this up as you go along. And then if you just make a little note, so this is rust brown. Wash your brush and go to your next colour. So we've got scarlet red next. So again, in a teaspoon of water. Mix that together and then do a little test swatch. Yellow. So that's a mid yellow, these different shades. And one more, so we're just going to choose four to work with. Pink, probably the bright pink. Okay, so now we might want to blend some of these together. So again, we're going to go back to our pipette. So have a look at the colours in here. So I've got more of a darker brown as well, so I'm going to get the rust brown. So just put a few drops the same amount, so I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wash my pipette out, and then get some of the red. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I know now that they're the same amount. So mix that together. And do another little swatch here. Okay. And then on my notes, I'm going to write 50-50 rust brown and red. Okay. So I'm starting to blend my colours. So we'll do a little test swatch with that. So the fabric that we're going to use is a synthetic fabric. So it's 100% polyester, so it has to be 100% polyester synthetic for it to work with a dispersed dye. So that has to dry now, so let that dry 100% and then we'll print it on the heat press. Okay. Start back from the first stage. So when your dispersed dye samples have dried, we need to print them onto the fabric to test the colours. So just check that they're fully dry, so I can see that these have all dried. So for the heat press, we need to check the temperature. So the temperature to print is 400 Fahrenheit. So you'll see the numbers on here. So as long as it's waving between 380 to 400, that's definitely hot enough. So for this type of fabric, we're only going to need to print it for about 10 to 15 seconds. It's only a small sample, it's quite a thin fabric. So using newsprint, this is going to protect the heat press and the fabric. If we didn't put newsprint on, the fabric would melt to the very hot heat press. So the heat comes from the top, not the bottom. So be careful around the heat press that you don't touch the top iron. And if you've got really long hair or scarves on, then either tie your hair back or remove the scarf. So put the print down with your fabric. Use a fabric face side, so that's the side you want the print to go on, face side down. And I'll just put that on there and cover it up. Okay, pull. Press down, you have to push really hard and just hold it down for around 10 seconds. So you'll see the time going down on the timer. Okay, then both hands pull it up and push it right up to the top. Carefully take your print out. So it will be hot, so just be careful. You can see that it's printed onto the fabric. Okay, so that's your test one. So what I would do is staple that on there and put that in your sketchbook so you know what colours you chose, and you can build those up and use that as a reference. So they'll print differently on different fabrics. So this one is a much more shiny fabric called satin, so you'll get a more brighter effect. And this one's called crepe de chine polyester, so it's a bit more matte. So depending on what results you want to get, you can think about your fabric choice beforehand. Tested our colours and we're happy with them. We're going to refer back to the photograph, and on an A3 piece of paper, we're going to start to put some colour down onto the paper using the dispersed dye. So when we're doing this painting, we're not being fine artists, we're being textile designers. So we're more interested in looking where the colour and the shapes and patterns are, and just seeing where that's going to fall on the paper. But we are going to cut it up shortly. So if we think about these like boulders first of all, so I'm just looking where the colour is falls on the paper. So I've got this round in here, maybe one next to it. There. I'm just looking where the shapes and patterns fall on the paper. Start to build it up. It's probably going to take you about a good 20 minutes to do this and get all the colours down onto your paper. Shaking patterns from the pebbles and the seaweed. So you can mix them and blend them together just like watercolours really. Okay, so as that starts to come together, it should start to look something along the lines of this later brown. Okay. What I want you to do for the next stage is we're going to create a series of silhouette shapes and patterns, and this is what you're going to need for the workshop. So to make these shapes and patterns, we're going to go back to the photograph with some tracing paper. So simply just put the tracing paper over your photocopy and start to pick out shapes and patterns. So I'm going to pick out little bits of the seaweed. Okay. Some of the pebbles. So we're picking out lots of shapes and patterns. You can then transfer those easily onto paper. So by turning that over, okay, and then you'll be able to draw or cut them out. So once you've got a full sheet of lots of shapes and patterns, just using paper scissors, you're going to cut them all out. You've got lots of different shapes. And then on the back of your paper, you're going to draw around them. So put them all on and just start to draw. Draw around them all individually and you can turn them over so one way and another, so you're getting lots of shapes and patterns on there. Okay, so I want you to fill this sheet all over with all the shapes and patterns, and then you're going to just cut them out with scissors. So take your time. And cut them all out. Okay, so you'll have a lot when you finish. You can see what I've got here, what I've done earlier. So keep those safe in a plastic wallet until we're ready to print.